Ladies and gentlemen, honorable guests, it's my pleasure to address this video message to you at the second international conference on the tangible and intangible impact of information and communication in the digital age. I would have preferred to address you in person. I'm nonetheless very pleased to be able to share this message with you today. Information and knowledge are crucial to human development. Digital technologies are increasingly employed in organizing, assessing, disseminating, using, and preserving information and knowledge. Such technologies can improve people's life and livelihoods, extend effective access to information and knowledge, further access to scientific research, deepen dialogue and mutual understanding around culture and linguistic diversity, help address global challenges that threaten the future of humanity, including security threats, conflict, forced migration, violent extremism, and climate change. UNESCO's concept of building inclusive knowledge societies captures the power of technology for the achievement of sustainable development, as set out in the United Nations 2030 Agenda. Since 2001, the Information for All program, IFAP, has played an important role creating equitable knowledge societies through better access to information. The overall goal of IFAP is to advise and support member states to develop and implement national information policies and knowledge strategies in a world increasingly using digital technologies. I want to take this opportunity to reiterate my full commitment to reinforce IFAP, a key intergovernmental program of UNESCO, and its activities in the coming years. Access to information remains key to empowering citizens and enabling them to contribute to the realization of the Sustainable Development Goals. And that is why IFAP is such an important program for us. Knowledge societies should take due account of the digital divides that remain a global challenge. Despite the growth in use of digital technologies, the distribution of access between developed and developing countries, between urban and rural communities, and between different age groups and genders, is still inequitable. These digital divides can be addressed through UNESCO's initiative and engagement in building human capacities. The advancement of digital skills is important in order to ensure that all human beings can fulfill their potential in dignity and equality, and as a result can enjoy prosperous and fulfilling lives through economic, social, and technological progress. When advocating for national information policies and knowledge strategies, it's key to align the normative frameworks with the values of the UN Charter, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, and the norms and standards of international law. Important guidelines are provided in UNESCO's Knowledge Societies Policy Handbook, which provides policymakers with conceptual frameworks for understanding and assessing the relationships between the Sustainable Development Agenda, human rights, and the pillars of knowledge societies. Integrating the human rights dimension is essential for fostering peaceful, just, and inclusive societies. Equally important is the promotion of cultural diversity and multilingualism, especially in the digital age. Enabling citizens to access information in their own languages is key, as it empowers them to contribute to the development of their societies. In that regard, I very much look forward to participating in the IFAP International Conference, Preservation of Languages and Development of Linguistic Diversity in Cyberspace, Contest, Policies, Practices, in Yakutsk, in Russia Federation, next July. Several initiatives have been advanced through IFAP, such as the Girls Can Code project. The project aims at training teenagers between the ages of 11 and 14 from 10 schools across Ghana, bringing equity and narrowing the gap between men and women in the use of digital technologies. Allow me also to highlight the importance of partnerships to address the impact of technology on society in a holistic way. The value and principles of multi-stakeholder partnerships with government, the private sector, civil society, international organizations, the technical and academic communities, and all other relevant stakeholders is vital for knowledge societies. Strengthened global solidarity through modalities such as IFAP is essential for overcoming the social, economic, and cultural challenges faced by knowledge societies. I see this conference reflects this global solidarity with participants from more than 40 countries. This conference is also a good example of the governing power of IFAP national committees in building partnerships for information for development, information literacy, information preservation, information ethics, and information accessibility and multilingualism. As you know, IFAP national committees pursue the goals of IFAP at the national level by serving as a meeting point for various stakeholders and as an avenue for the transfer of knowledge from the international to the national level. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Russian IFAP committee for taking the initiative of bringing us together to deliberate on the impact of technology on development. This event is one of the series of events that underscores the role of the Russian IFAP committee through the IFAP vice chair in leading the working group on multilingualism. Cultural diversity and multilingualism in cyberspace are cornerstones for building pluralistic, equitable, and inclusive knowledge societies achieving sustainable development. I wish you all the best in your deliberations, and we look forward to the outcome of your discussion. Thank you very much.